This could be epic. Set for three rounds, but we don't think it'll go the distance. Both athletes are sporting their left way trucks.
Judge.
Shirt ready, and Sultane from Yangon, Myanmar. Shirtwini in the red, Sultane in the black and white. We are going to see some very fine striking here. And already the combination's becoming evident from Shirtwini.
Watch the right hand of Yetwini. It comes out of nowhere and it comes with such a pace and velocity.
Very long 8-week camp for Shirtwini. Predicted the hands would damage and knock out Sultane here tonight. Fake there from Shirtwini in the red. Overhand right, tries to thread it. And good evasion from Sultane. Roundhouse kick, tries to fold him in hard. Looks to clinch up. Cuts off the cage, the Shirtwini. Short left hand from Sultane.
Sultane's got a nice straight right hand and it's landing consistently.
Good little spinning back fist there. Didn't quite have the mustard behind it though. Both men drift to center cage. Catch and counter from Shirtwini.
Good forward pressure from Shirtwini. Nice high guard. Keeping his face well protected. There's that right hand again. It's coming.
Jab, Sultane. Good counter left from Shirtwini. Spinning back fist from Sultane. A lot of boxing here in the opening round. We are seeing pretty much a modified left way battle.
Not a lot of clinches, not a lot of takedowns going on here, just a lot of wild strikes.
And have a look at Shirtwini calling his opponent forward. Back elbow, step through there. Not enough power behind it from Sultane. Looping punches again from Shirtwini. Just trying to walk down Sultane, trying to cut him off, trying to catch him. May have stunned him there. Look at Shirtwini. Now the clinch from him. And Sultane with some fast footwork, some clever footwork. Flash of roundhouse kicks negates each other.
Sultane has taken some big shots here because Shirtwini is landing with that right hand over and over again. Consistently went after the head, was mixing up his target, and consistently connecting on the chin.
Yeah, Tony!
Success on the feet, so he's got to let those hands go and keep this match standing.
Patel, known as God's warrior from his parents, strong Christian faith. His hobby is freestyle rapping. circles off counterclockwise here, just getting out of the range of that right hand. A nice little gut-munching knee there from the Japanese.
He's got to stay away from this clinch. He's got to circle the way, try to get those underhooks and spin off and keep moving. You can see Fujisawa just so strong inside that clinch. He's going to transition, puts back doll down. He's back to where he doesn't want to be. And that's on the bottom position with Fujisawa.
4:10 remains, third and final round of this second preliminary match here at ONE Championship, Conquest of Champions, from the mighty Mall of Asia Arena in Manila, the Philippines. Fujisawa in the camouflage, top position. Biggest night in ONE Championship tonight with a double main event. Heavyweight world title, lightweight world title, both on the line. Plenty of ONE Super Series action as well coming your way.
He's got the feet on the inside. He could maybe create a little bit of space, use that fence to walk up, but it's so hard if he's not able to push Fujisawa away. He's got the feet on the hips, so he could create a little bit of elevation, move him away, but Fujisawa has got that cage control.
That's all glances towards his corner. Want to finish? The trainer, J.R. Chrysologo. The Lions Head Boxing Gym in Yorkie Mixed Martial Arts. Based out of Bangkok, Thailand, although born here in the Philippines. Only 19 years old, 1-0 as a pro, 6-0 as an amateur. He's got a butterfly guard on Fujisawa here, and referee Olivier Coast wants to see a little more activity.
This is going to be a good learning experience for Rocky Bato. At 19 years old, going three hard rounds with a veteran like Fujisawa, it's going to be good for him because he's going to realize that, A, you can't get backed into the corner like this, and if you do get taken down, you've got to be able to get back up. Fujisawa picks him up, puts it down. But
not quite as impactful as he'd hoped for, perhaps, but still effective there from Fujisawa. Side control position, 220 down. It remains in the third. Good elbows there to the left eyebrow from the super jab.
It was almost like he was nice on that takedown. He picked him up and he gently put him down. It wasn't quite a boom shakalaka type takedown.
Not yet, Mitch, not yet. Bound to come out later on.
Sorry, I'll calm down.
We've got so many great takedown artists coming up on tonight's stacked card.
Oh, look at Bato. He might be trying to threaten a triangle right there, but good job by Fujisawa to control those legs. Steps over into the half now. This is a good position to be in, just if you want to deliver a bit of ground and pound. You know, you got that hip trap, you got the arm trap right there. You can really do a lot of damage from half guard.
And Rocky Bactol get the Philippines off to a winning start here in Manila. Half guard for Akihiro Fujisawa.
The first thing Bactol's got to do, he's got to take his right arm and he's got to try to swim it underneath the left arm of Fujisawa. He's trying to get that right arm underneath. Fujisawa's got such good awareness, but he's not letting it go. You want to go for the underhook? I'm going to elbow you in the face.
Fujisawa, one of three Japanese athletes on tonight's card. We've also got that Hulk of Humanity, Hideki Sugino, later on. And the explosive Hiroaki Suzuki in a ONE Super Series kickboxing match. Nice knee to the side of the head there from Fujisawa. Doubles up and at the jab. Nicely done again from the super jab.
He's pinned down the arm there. See, Bactol can't go anywhere as long until he gets that underhook on that right arm. You can see he's just going over the top with it, and that's just going to hold the head. Look at the head position of Fujisawa. He just plants that head, buries it under the chin of Bactol, and there's no place for Bactol to go.
On the ground and pound by Fujisawa, referee Olivier Coast dives in to save Rocky Bactol. Fujisawa gets the win.
He was able to really just deploy his game plan, attack the single legs, get the clinch, work and grind on Rocky Bactol until this moment presented itself and he was able to finish on top via ground and pound.
Akihiro Fujisawa!
So difficult for Muhamad Haidar, only 21 years old, to come into this arena and face not only his opponent, but all of the fans here who are clearly behind Danny Kingad as this arena fills up on its way towards our main card and our fabulous main event later on this evening. Here's our first fight of the night, though. And it's Danny Kingad in the red trunks, Muhamad Haidar in the black trunks.
Kingad's got an unconventional stance. He's keeping his left hand very low. He has a almost erratic footwork that he's debuting here. So he's really, I think the nerves might be a little bit, this is a big stage for him to be on right now, but he's so excited and he's so pumped to be here tonight. Kingad, on the other hand, looks very composed, relaxed, stalking forward, just kind of controlling the center of that cage.
Certainly a controlled start, as you say. Not much action yet, both very, very cautious, not wanting to make an error, and it's no surprise that Olivier Cost asks them to step up the pace a little bit, and they respond straight away.
See, Steve, there's that crushing leg kick that Kingad likes to throw. You typically see the Wushu fighters from Team Lakai throwing that push kick. But he likes to change it up and attack the legs. Nice double leg takedown by Kingad right there as he puts Haidar on his back, but he pops right back up and he goes right back down.
Heavy takedowns as well. The whole cage seemed to vibrate. Really have got a noisy crowd here, even in the early part of the evening.
Yeah, Kingad's real popular with the Filipino fans.
Any fighter that comes from the famed Team Lakai really kind of takes on the weight of the nation on their shoulders, and they support that weight very well indeed.
You can see Muhamad Haidar trying to slide out, but right now the fighters are dry. They haven't worked up a sweat yet, so it's really easy just to kind of hold on to your opponent and control them. So you really have to demonstrate really good technique in these early stages of this round where everybody is so fresh and so strong.
Olivier Cost will be on top of Danny Kingad to make sure he works to some kind of a finish. At the moment, he's using his elbows and his forearm to try and create some damage.
See, Kingad just got easily let, you know, slide up on the top, and he's just dropping the punches down on top.
And
really
it's not
going to
last much longer, Mitch. That's it. You could see that Muhamad Haidar was intent only on covering up. There was no way he was going to throw any punches back from that position.
Nice little entry here as Kingad slides in for the double leg, picks him up, sends him for the ride, and it looks like Haidar just kind of holds on, so Kingad picks him up again and puts him back down on his back. And that was just the beginning of the end for Muhamad Haidar.
Danny Kingad!
That's when Chan Rotana gets so dangerous, is when he gets that confidence flowing and he starts throwing those heavy shots. As Chan Rotana just tried to look into the soul of Rudy Agustin as he glared through the corner at him. Look at that. Nice little straight right hand to a left hook combination. See, Chan Rotana starting to get a little bit light on his feet. Now he's starting to move around a little bit. Not so flat footed, not so planted.
Rotana knows that Rudy Agustin is fading a little bit, so he's using his footwork here, not allowing Agustin to time him for the takedown.
Kind of misses on a big leg kick as he lets out a little wail. Rudy Agustin lets him know he appreciates that shot right there. As soon as Rudy Agustin closes that distance, gets into that striking range, Chan Rotana throws a big right hand.
Chan Rotana is not afraid to throw combinations in three rounds. He has the conditioning to do that.
Like that body kick, like how he's starting to work in this way. Rudy Agustin might be starting to fade. There's no takedown attempts coming. Nice hand combination thrown by Chan Rotana.
This is what Rudy Agustin wants. Rudy Agustin wants Chan Rotana to commit on the striking exchange and look to another change off it.
Chan Rotana looks to be the fresher of the two as we're approaching the 3-minute mark of the second round of this mixed martial arts contest. I like the leg kicks, I like Chan Rotana throwing those leg kicks. It's gonna slow down that shot attempt coming from Rudy Agustin. He's throwing that uppercut from way back from Phnom Penh.
Chan Rotana doing a great job of doing long range strikes, not overcommitting, not allowing Rudy Agustin space to clinch up.
Nice
Nice little fake there. Beautiful left kick, straight right hand combination. This is not the same Rudy Agustin that we saw in the first. He expended a lot of takedown as he runs right into a knee.
You have to think, Mitch, is Rudy Agustin trying to conserve energy for the third round, trying to push hard? Not a good strategy against Chandler Tana, who's known to be able to go three rounds.
Chandler Tana's piecing him apart right now as he catches the kick, throws him to the ground. Here comes the ground and pound by Chandler Tana. Oh, Rudy Agustin's got move. Chandler Tana's gonna go right past this guard. Might end up in side control or mount. Big right hand landing.
Agustin not doing much in terms of defense.
That's it.
He needs to lock up Chandler Tana here. He can't just defend.
He's got to intelligently defend himself. Otherwise, Kim Chang is being forced to jump in and stop this.
Try to slow down the attacks of Chandler Tana. Try to get it under her.
Good job. At least Chandler Tana was still able to lock in a guillotine. Chooses to switch around, take the back. Keeps punching. Beautiful stoppage.
Poured on the pressure in the second round. Kept his range really well, never allowed any opportunity for Rudy Agustin to get his grappling in. Here, on the back position, unanswered right hands. Referee has no choice but to stop this bout.
John Rotana!
Fighter. Come here. Guys, you have one round to finish that fight, all right? Let's go. Back to your corner.
The boss, Olivia Koss, the instructions for the third and final. John, will it be a successful return for Tony Taurin? Will it be a victorious debut for Gurdasham Mangat of India? And now we feel a bit more gusto, we feel a bit more pepper. They've upped the intensity here, Mitch.
Yeah, the boss came out and told them that they needed this to finish the match in this round. They got 5 minutes to put it on them, so. And they're actually, they're trying right now. They're throwing hands.
Outside leg kick there from Mangat.
Oh, there's the left hand from Mangat. And he dropped Taurin. Taurin sprung back to his feet, but here comes the Indian. Here comes Gurdasham Mangat. And he drives down Taurin. Top position now.
Oh, that's smart by Mangat to hurt him on the feet, drop him with the left hand, and then to swarm all over him and get that takedown.
Up position for Mangat.
But I think Tony Taurin actually is, that's in his favor. He's able to recover now. He's going to be able to clear the cobwebs out from that big shot that Mangat landed, which dropped him. And now he's in his world. Now he can start working the guard.
And Mangat, oh, he skips around to the back of Taurin. What's he going to do from here? The Indian, he drives a knee. And look. Gurdasham Mangat, the confidence flowing now. He's done the damage to Taurin. Taurin locks onto a leg. Hammer fist strike, it's all over. Gurdasham Mangat wins on debut. That's a huge win for Mangat. That's a huge win for Indian mixed martial arts.
Watch this left hand. Mangat slips back. Boom, right on the butt. Crumbles Taurin. And then the veteran, the kick kicks in. He chooses to take Taurin down. Going into Taru's world, jumping knee up against the cage, and then just starts dropping the hammer fists.
Gurdasham Mangat!